Well, g'day, g'day, and welcome back again to Jiaqing. And today we are going back to Shenzhen. It was our last night in Shenzhen. So our last video, we were at the Window of the World petting zoo. And after we finished there, we went over the road to the shopping center for dinner and stuff. And yeah, so we're going to take you for a little walk through the shopping center there. So yeah, this is our last night. We finished at the shopping center. Once we finished there, back in the car, we drove back to Yunfu. Jimmy had work the next day. So yeah, we had to get back that night. Candy and her family stayed on for another day. Just outside here where we're sitting now, before we take you back to the main video, we'll see we have all of our students. So these are all the comprehensive school students, sort of high school age, out doing their PE stuff. Various things going on around here. But we're not gonna stay and focus on that one. We're going to head you back to Shenzhen. And then from there, just so you know what's coming up, the video is coming up in the near future. I think from memory, we were into the Walking with the King festival, which was fascinating festival. All the villages around Sing Sing do this festival, but they all do it very, very differently. So it's all the same festival, but each little village does it in their own style. It was amazing to watch. You go, we went and saw, I think, four of them. There were, I don't even know how many, maybe 10 or 12 of these festivals around the place. And you can go and see all of them and not see the same thing. Well, apart from the firecrackers going off, every festival was very different. So yeah, so that's coming up in the near future. But in the meantime, enjoy a quick look around. What did we do? We did two floors of a 7-level shopping center. It's just unbelievably big. The one we saw the other day, I don't even remember the name of it. It's tiny compared to this place. So yeah, sit back and enjoy a look around at sort of what China does in a big shopping mall. Okay, so we've just had a bite to eat in this shop here, Cafe de Coral, which was very nice. Have a look at this. We've just had a dinner brought to us on a robot. Unbelievable. So this thing just wanders around the restaurant delivering everybody's food. So you get a little token when you order your food, which has a little barcode thing in it. And here's dinner. We've got sort of like a pork chocolate thing. We've got a sort of bolognese sauce with rice and a bottle of Coke. So we're going to have dinner, and then we're going to take you for a little wander through the shopping center here. Well, we're going to take you through one floor of the shopping center. We're not going to go right through the whole thing. It's too big. There's this robot again, heading around. So this means, so you get your token with your number on it. And it's quite a big restaurant here. There's a lot of tables. So this means the waitress isn't running around trying to find where she's meant to take this food to. So the robot heads there, the waitress just follows. So the tokens that you get have these amazing little things, chips in them, so the robot can just find its way to the thing. The waitress follows and then puts the food out.
We'll just give you a quick look sort of around the sites here. So over the road here is this, I can't remember, something of the world or something. It's a big area. We haven't been through much of it, but over there is where that animal petting farm was. We've got a big tower here. We've got these, I don't even know what's over here, but looks like a sort of, I don't know, like a Walt Disney sort of thing on top of the building here. It's a bit hard to see, but what we're going to do is we're going to just wander through here into the shopping center. We're just going to take a stroll through one level of this shopping center. So this is just ginormous. We are on the, I think we're on the, yeah, we must be basement one level. So up above us here is the road. So we're actually below ground level at the moment. This shopping center, so once we've walked through, basically times it by seven. There's three basement levels and then four above ground levels. And this also connects to the, to the metro system. There's a huge big bus station down below us. So we can see here, oh, we got some guys coming through in cosplay outfits, which looks really cool. All the makeup and stuff. So we've got, goes down here, and then there's another level below this level. And then we got four floors up above us. Goes right the way up. But we're only gonna concentrate on this one. We're actually gonna walk down to the other end. The guys we're with are having dinner at a restaurant one level below us, down at the far end of the shopping center here. So look up here, it's mind-boggling. And then there's actually we didn't go up and have a look, there's actually an open air area up on top of the roof as well. So it just goes on and on. So what have we got up here? We've got a Lego section in here. We've got a big Starbucks. Over to our left, oh, look at this. Look at this beast of a car. What's this? Hi-Fi. I've never heard of these guys before. What a beastie looking car. Let's see if we can just go around the corner here, see if we can find some information on this thing. So it must be electric, I would imagine. God, that looks like an absolute beast. Now here's some bit of information. 810 kilometers. If that's got a range of 810 kilometers. Wow, and look at how the doors open here. Wow. Let's just shoot through and have a little look. So we've got reversing cameras on there, sensors all the way around. Just looks like an absolute beast. Wow, anyone who thinks China can't make cars, I'll tell you what, that is absolutely phenomenal. We've got cameras on the side here, sitting up in here. And then all digital displays inside. Wow, that looks absolutely stunning. Okay, we have a DJI store in here, so drones, action cameras, all that sort of stuff. Looks really cool. Love the DJI gear. I'm going to be spending some money on DJI in the next year. So here again, looking down. So looks like lots of clothing stuff on this level. The next level up was clothing stuff. Up above that, I think, was electronics. And then above that, the fourth floor is all restaurants. It's it's a huge, huge shopping center. The one we were in last night, I thought was pretty big, but God, I think this is even bigger. Also, all perfumes and stuff here. I'm not sure whether it's perfumes or aftershave or something along those lines. I don't use any of it myself. Oh, look at this huge big screen here. So we've got another, who's that? Aito, A-I-T-O, another car company down there. Got a Huawei stall in there. There's also a big Huawei store somewhere we walk past, I can't remember where it is, but this screen goes all the way up to the top floor. That's just massive. So that's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 floors high. Unbelievable. Okay, and then, oh, have a look at some of this stuff in here. This is really nice. Very nice sort of jewelry stuff in there. And a very nicely fitted out shop as well. Looks really good. Made in Israel. Don't know how I feel about Israel right at the moment with all the stuff going on in the Middle East. I think we'll boycott that for the time being. I think we might be having to... Okay, so... Oh no, we're around the corner here. All right, there is... It's starting to look like we're coming to the end, but... No, there's lots more. Another car company here, a couple of cars. Also Chinese-made electric cars. They are proving to be very, very popular. The SUV is... selling like hotcakes, apparently. Then, we have this over on the left here was, I'm not even sure what this stuff is here, but it looked an interesting little store. So this is all these little, I don't even know what they are, really. Robots and stuff. All coming soon. So something like this here. We're looking 240 RMB, 169 RMB. I don't know what they are. They must come from a television show of some form or other, but I can't tell you what the television show would be. Okay, over on our right here, we have a big iPhone store. It is absolutely huge. Now, we're at the level, so the shopping center stops at this sort of distance at this level because the road's in the way, but we might just head up a level because I think up here, the shopping center actually carries on further along, I think. No, maybe not. We have to go up a couple of levels for it to carry on. We're going to go back down. We're not going to do a walk through the whole thing because that could take hours. that was just a quick stroll through here. We will head down to the bottom floor, which has more restaurants and all that sort of stuff. And from there, we are going to go and find our family, see how they're going with their dinner, see if they've finished eating. So I don't know what their plans are for after dinner. Okay, so they're still eating. So we're gonna take a little, we've come down to the basement 2 level. We're going to take a little stroll through here and give you a little look through here as well. So we're right down the far end from where we just finished. So first up above us here, we have this screen running right the way around, ring right the way around this level where the escalators are. Just mind-blowing. We've got a Dairy Queen here. We have... the Kung Fu Froggy. So if you like to eat frog, that's the place to go. I've never been able to bring myself to eat frog. It just doesn't sit well with me. I tried it once. We ended up going to a restaurant next door and buying me some chicken while the people I was with were eating frog. So yeah, that was interesting to say the least. Oh, we have some virtual reality stuff here again. So big chairs to sit in. Wow, look at that. Looks a looks a job and a half doing that. We have some sort of model stuff in here. Looks like we have a Xiaomi store opening soon on our left. So we have some games being played in here. Right, and then on our way through, lots of clothing stuff. There seems to be lots of these places in the middle of the mall. These sort of stalls set up seem to be all sort of short-term stuff for people selling things cheap, discount stuff. What are these? These XPeng. So we've got a number of cars in here. This P7 is a great little car. I've seen this on the road before. I'm pretty sure that's the one I've seen on the road. Looks fantastic. Bit more SUV-ish, and then a bit more of a people carrier here. Let's see what we've got in the end here. This is... So we're two floors below ground level, and we've got a full-on four-wheel drive. So all electric. They're all electric cars. It's absolutely... So yeah, we're two levels below ground level here. I wonder how they get the cars. I wonder how they get the cars in and out. Well, I guess you come in here to look, buy a car, and pick it up from somewhere else. So iFlyTech. So we've just spent probably 20-25 minutes chatting to the lady in here about the new tech, the new translation gear. So I've actually got one of their really, really old things I bought about 5 years ago, which was really, really good, but they've come so far since then. Samsung, yeah, I've got version 2. I think they're up to version 5 now. So they just keep on moving along. Technology just advances so fast, it's hard to keep up with everything that's happening. So this here will take you down to basement 3 level, which we're not going to do. Over on our right here, just past this stall, we have a big Huawei store. Plenty of people in there with the new Mate 60 Pro. It's a great phone from all I've heard. Jewelry store. Then this is this Huawei stand we had, so Nova. Nova being the sort of cheap version of Huawei, I think. Yogurt store, frozen yogurt. And then you can do, you get your yogurt dropped out through here and you pay by how much you get and then toppings to put on top of the yogurts. Okay, we have the supermarket in here. Wow, that does look really good in there, actually. That looks like a pretty stylish for a supermarket. Okay, so they're called Ole. It is a nice looking shop, but I guess being in a shopping center like this, you do have to have a bit of style and a bit of class. Oh, what's around to the other side here? I haven't even had a look down this way. Okay, that one's heading down to the metro station. More jewelry through here. So, the translation stuff, from what, I mean, I had version 2 of their translation tool, which worked really well. It could even pick up, test it out. It's got so when you pick English, you can pick American English, English, South African, Australian. So I hooked it up Australian English and even picked up, I really hammed up the accent and stuff and used a bit of slang to test it out. And it seemed to figure it all out pretty well. So amazing tool. And you can only imagine where they are now. Just phenomenal piece of equipment. We've actually just bought some more in our school. I think they were iFlyTech. It's the latest earbud translators.
which we had a quick play with before the holidays, but me and Frankel are going to sit down after the holidays, spend a bit more time playing around with them, and see just how good they are. Let's go around the back of... Ah, so this is the... It's the same company, Hi-Fi, that we saw that car in the... On this level, on the level above. Look at that, that just looks amazing. What an amazing piece of equipment. I don't know that I like that color very much. I think I prefer the one that we saw upstairs. So we're now back at the restaurant, so we're going to turn ourselves off here and go and see how everybody's going. Oh, the girls are out the front here trying to win a prize with the claw machine here. But for now, it's goodbye. So hit the like button, subscribe, share, all that stuff. Questions, comments, hit us up in the comments section and we'll endeavor to answer any questions you have. Stay safe, take care everybody, and we will see you all in the next one. Cheers. So here we have the window of the world. So we've got sort of Roman or Greek pillars there. We've got an Eiffel Tower. We've got a beautiful dragon over here. We've got Christmas tree. We've got big buildings behind us. The shopping center's back through there. And then we're heading off this way. Ah, so it looks like we've actually got a bit of a replica of the amphitheater up behind here. It's a bit hard to see at night. We're going to have to come back, do another trip here to Shenzhen another time, and come and spend more time in some of these places. Look at these dragons up on all of these pillars here. Absolutely gorgeous. It's a beautiful little spot. And look at these up here. This is just amazing spot. Like I say, we'll have to get back to Shenzhen sometime soon and explore more of this city. We'll spend a bit more time. We've only been here a few days and we're sort of following these guys around and haven't had the chance to really explore terribly much of the stuff I'd want to explore. This glittering tower here must be a, I don't know, if an elevator shaft or something going down into the underground. City Inn on our left. Oh, look at this. Beautiful, beautiful buildings. All sort of done up in European styles. Looks absolutely amazing. And then we're getting closer to this sparkling tower. I don't know. Oh, this is just an entrance gate, is it? The place of nectar. We saw that earlier. It looks so much better under lights. Goodness. Here we have this, some sort of entrance statement. Look at that. Try and get our way up here a little bit. Wow, that looks just amazing. Absolutely incredible. And looking through to our left here, beautiful buildings in here. It's a beautiful looking spot. We're definitely going to have to come back, do some exploring in here sometime soon.